Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we have the Guild Wars 2 End of Dragons Jade Sea map preview trailer to go over, watch, and analyze. So, first and foremost, let's play the trailer. Alright everyone, the Jade Sea. Honestly, first impressions, not gonna lie, I'm a little excited. I love the color palette, I really enjoy the bright, clear skies, and I do enjoy the overall landscapes that we've seen. Of course, we're gonna go deeper into the trailer itself, kind of go frame by frame almost, and talk about the things that we've seen. But overall, this was a pretty good trailer. I was under the impression that like the Jade Sea honestly isn't the most visually complex or diverse with my knowledge of it from the very first game. So with Guild Wars 2, I wasn't necessarily expecting a whole lot of new things, but of course with Guild Wars 2 and of course the time span from Guild Wars 1 factions to Guild Wars 2's Cantha, there will of course be differences, updates to models, and I was really excited to see a lot of new interesting assets and also some little cities and village areas. So let us go through the trailer kind of frame by frame and see what we can pull from this. So first we have the splash page, of course, introducing the Jade Sea map preview. And then the very first shot, honestly, is what set the standard for this map in terms of like what I expect to see during the actual live stream, is this new, really intricate asset. I don't believe we've ever seen a model akin to this, so this is one of the very new assets for the expansion. From the other trailers, we've kind of seen Canthan-esque housing architecture, and especially with the Echovald Wilds, we've kind of seen a lot of the vegetation in other areas of Guild Wars 2. But this in particular, with the jade background, with the mines, with this almost like drill saw contraption that harvests the jade and probably its magic, I've never seen this before. And it looks super, super cool. It looks really sleek. And this is what I would have loved to have seen kind of more of with the other maps. But you gotta have one or two like really solid statement pieces for an expansion, and this kind of feels like it is one of them. So we continue on. There's a man, of course, with new jade weapons, gonna say. They were using the old jade weapons, but these seem to be new, and they are probably going to be a weapon set that we can collect in Cantha, with a sword and what appears to be a war horn. And it continues with a nice little bridge shot, some waterfalls and extra agriculture and extra foliage. And then we have this lovely city shot. I want to explore this so badly. It looks really, really cool. There's even like a little holographic person on the right, towards the right of the screen. And on top of the actual roofs, there seem to be like sails or some sort of generator, which is also interesting. And then throughout this city, we do see a lot of jade accents. I believe I see a jade waypoint or something to do with a jade mastery track, because I kind of feel like that'll be the fifth mastery track, not gonna lie. So we do have some elements of the jade throughout this. It continues, and then we get a more scenic shot, a more quote unquote basic shot, but still setting the tone of a more open mine. This is reminiscent and reminds me a lot of the mining area near Amnoon City in Path of Fire. So I really enjoyed that mine, and I kind of hope to see more with it in the story of Path of Fire and get to explore more of it, but it was kind of just in that little corner. But of course, with the Jade Sea and the Canthan's initiative to mine the jade and use its magic, we'll probably see more mines and like caverns and actual mining shafts. I hope to see that. Next shot, there is this waterfall or a little fountain area with this really cool dragon head. Could be a Saltspray Kunvang, or maybe it's Mother or the deep sea dragon. I have no idea. So we have this, and then we see the back shot of another warden. This warden seems to be wielding the Laystone hammer skin, which is nice, but this warden looks particularly different than the other warden that we saw in the Echoveld Wilds trailer. This seems to be possibly more of a female model of a warden, still having that like branching amalgamation coming out of their shoulder. And then we have, of course, the crown, which is not like so much a stag, which is kind of just like a larger fan of branches. So we continue on and we see this little shot of the Jade Sea, the actual curvature of the waves that we saw in Guild Wars 1. Throughout this trailer, we didn't really see a large expanse shot, a wider open plains shot. They were kind of more punched in, focusing on specific set pieces and vistas. So this is kind of at least reminiscent of Guild Wars 1's aesthetic of having the wide open jade plains with the curling waves. So we get a little bit of that. There seemed to be some magic flowing through it, a little outpost with some people. And then we of course see the individuals mining, the Canthan mines. Once again, another shot of some weapons, what appears to be the sword and the war horn. Get another shot of the jade golems that we saw in Echoveld Wilds. And then it transitions over to a little shot of two people on a skiff in some underground or watery cave. I think it's really cool if we actually have like little caves and coves that we can explore underneath the jade that they've like mined out some passageways to actually maneuver through the waters, or that it's just melted naturally. But especially with the mining initiative, I imagine we'll see some more pathways to go down and travel. Maybe not to the extent of Tangled Depths and the maze-like structure of Tangled Depths, but definitely some extra areas to utilize our skiffs and to travel across the map, perhaps. Or have an underwater event or two. The jade itself powers the Canthan Empire, and then we have this lovely shot of what appears to be a mechanist wielding what I can only say is the mechanist elite spec weapon. We've never seen it in game. I don't think we've ever seen any of the elite specialization weapons, the specific weapons that arrive and you craft as that elite specialization. We haven't seen it. And that was a really big downside, I think, of the profession trailers, is that they were using weapons that were already in game, and we never actually got to see that specific elite specialization weapon in action or see how it looks, how it moves. We finally get to see something with the elite specialization weapon, and the mechanist mace fist mace. It looks so good. It looks so, so nice. And we kind of can transition over. It's just a lot of mine shots, a lot of sweeping vistas of the cities, some more architecture. And we see this little jade structure. We've seen throughout the live streams these little jade batteries or jade consoles. And then we have this other jade structure. It doesn't look to be a waypoint, but it looks to be some other system. This could be like a jade bomb or a jade mine, not in terms of the mines, but something you step over and it explodes. I don't know if the people that we're looking at and the golem are actually friendly or if they are hostile. If they are, this could be some sort of trap or some sort of alarm system. Not exactly certain, but when it comes to the jade, I'm really interested to see if they will bring a mastery with our interaction with the jade, and I hope it's exciting. I hope it's more interesting than Icebeard Saga's waystation stuff. And then we have this other sweeping shot of some characters walking by the drill and mining construct. It looks really, really nice. Having another shot of it is lovely to see. And then it transitions more so over to some more shots of the mine, and we have some fighting with a Kappa, just some little action shots here and there. We can go under the drill. There seems to be a saw there. having a little bit more of the mechanist. And then we see the Jade Maw. They are reusing the Jade Maw in the open world. And this would maybe give some explanation to the Jade Maw fractal, as the Jade Maw was encapsulated in the jade in the fractal that was launched so many years ago. It makes sense that we will find some sort of creature of the Jade Maw and hopefully get some more lore as to what this creature is. Is this a minion of the Deep Sea Dragon? Is this Mother? I kind of hope Mother and the Deep Sea Dragon are different entities. So I hope this is a Deep Sea Dragon minion that can get some more lore. I'm really interested to see more about the Deep Sea Dragon. I feel like we haven't gotten that much lore on them, which is rather interesting. But yeah, more so than seeing this, it's really awesome to see this come back into the core game, into the open world. I'm really interested to see how they will change the fight, and I really hope they change the fight. We have the Jade Elementals, and it seems that we will be, like, trying to grab the crystals to defend ourselves from its blasts or something. I do hope there's more to this fight than just a straight up copy and paste, but I have faith that we will see some changes and some different mechanics that we have to encounter with the open world version of the Jade Maw. So it's really cool, really awesome set piece boss, encounter boss, see some people fighting. You see some pools, so there are maybe some different things that you have to interact with, and like not standing in certain areas, etc., etc. But it looks really, really nice, and I'm super excited to see more for the Jade Sea. So that is the trailer and my overall reaction and thoughts and slight analysis to the Jade Sea trailer. It looks really nice, but once again, we have more to see with the live stream coming this Friday, if you're watching this relatively around the day that I'm actually posting these. But I will be really excited to watch that, explore more of the Jade Sea, and then all that will be left is New Kainang coming next year. So thank you everyone so much. Comment below your thoughts on the Jade Sea trailer. Did you enjoy it? Did you want to see more? Did you want to get maybe a little bit more sense of the open plains of Jade? I know I would have maybe liked to see a little bit more of that. What about the Jade Maw? You vibing with it? Subscribe, comment down below, like, share, and if you'd like to pre-order End of Dragons, I have links down below to make sure you have a secured slot to journey into Cantha. And if you'd like to get videos early, I have a Patreon. Thank you all once again, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye everyone!